Welcome back. So let's talk about a few applications of double integrals here in section 12.5. And in particular, what I'd like to focus on today are the concepts of the mass of a two-dimensional object, such as a thin plate, and the center of mass of a two-dimensional object, such as a thin plate, allowing the density of the object to vary. Perhaps it's more dense in one location than it is in another location. So let's get started. So suppose we do have something like a thin plate, some sort of essentially two-dimensional object, occupying a region R in the xy plane. And let's suppose that the object has a density of a function called rho of xy. Rho, I think, is the traditional notation. Then how can we calculate the total mass of the plate? We can simply calculate the double integral over the region R of the density function, and that will give us the total mass. Now, we have described this in terms of mass density. You integrate the mass density of the object, mass per unit area, and you get the total mass. But there are other kinds of density as well. So for example, charge density, if you integrate that, it will give you total charge. So this idea applies to more situations than we're going to study. Now, in terms of the center of mass of the object, the balancing point, the centroid, to begin to build up the formula for the center of mass, we're going to start by introducing two quantities called the moment about the x-axis and the moment about the y-axis. The moment about the x-axis, which is called m sub x, is equal to the double integral over the region R of the quantity y rho of xy. And the moment about the y-axis, which is called m sub y, is given by the double integral of x rho xy. So now that we have established the formulas for these two quantities, m sub x and m sub y, let's use them to calculate the center of mass of an object. The center of mass has coordinates that are traditionally denoted by x with a bar over it and y with a bar over it. And if you want to find the x-coordinate of the center of mass, what you do is you take the moment about the y-axis and you divide it by the object's total mass. So it may be helpful to actually write these formulas out in full to find the center of mass at the x-coordinate, integrate over r, x times rho xy, integrate over r, rho xy. Now to find y bar, it's simply the opposite. We take the moment about the x-axis and divide it by the total mass. Or you may find it more helpful, and I personally find it easier to remember, that we can just take the double integral of y times rho xy and divide it by the integral of the density rho xy. I find this formula at the end slightly easier to remember than this one that references moments. So let's try a concrete example. Let's consider a thin plate occupying the region R, which is bounded by the curves y equals square root x and y equals x, with a density function of rho xy equals x. Let's find the total mass of the plate and subsequently the center mass of the plate. Okay, so we have this region R, and someone has been ever so kind as to tell us which functions bound our region on the top and on the bottom. We have y equals square root x, and we have y equals x. Now, we're considering the region between these two, and the values of x that are valid for this region stretch from 0 at their lowest to 1 at their highest. Because when x is 0, both square root of x and x are equal to 0. And likewise, when x is 1, square root x and x are both equal to 1. So our upper and lower curves meet. They intersect at that position. So now, let's create a double integral over the region R of the density function to find the total mass. Now you can do it with whatever order of integration you find satisfying, but I'm going to take the easy way out, and I'm going to integrate first with respect to y, because I have been told explicitly that y is equal to x is the bottom function for this region, and y equals square root x is the top function. Then I have the integral from 0 to 1 representing my x values. Finally, I have my density function, which is just equal to x. Now, if I integrate this first with respect to y, I get x squared, no, I get x times y, because I'm integrating with respect to y, from y equals x to y equals square root of x. And if I evaluate this, x times the square root of x simplifies to x to the 3/2, and x times x becomes x squared. If we evaluate this, we now have x to the 5/2 divided by 5/2, x to the 3rd power divided by 3, evaluated from 0 to 1. So we have 2/5 minus 1/3, which, based on this, I'm thinking 1 over 15. 1 over 15 is our total mass. Quite small. Okay, so now that we've calculated the total mass, let's start calculating some of the moments. And let's look at the moment, perhaps, in the y direction first. Moment about the y-axis. Now, the limits of integration are exactly the same as they were when we were calculating the total mass, because the region itself has not changed. The only thing that will change as we're calculating the moments is the integrand itself. So, the integral from x to root x, the integral from 0 to 1, of now x times the density function. Now, as before, we have x squared y evaluated from y equals x, y equals square root x. Which simplifies to x to the 5/2 minus x to the 6th. To the 3rd. And then integrating one more time. Integral. Let's just go for it. We have x to the 7/2. 2/7. 1/4, x to the 4th power, evaluated from 0 to 1. So this is 2/7, take away 1/4, I suppose that this is 1 over 28. Okay, and finally we have the moment about the x-axis to calculate. So let's get started on that. M sub x, which is found by integrating over exactly the same region R, but this time x times y. So when we find the antiderivative, now we have xy squared over 2. Y goes from x to square root x. And now if we plug that in, square root of x squared is x times x, x squared. And if we plug in y equals x, we get x cubed. And when we integrate this, we get x cubed over 6 minus x to the 4th over 8 from 0 to 1. And if I plug that in, we get 1 sixth, take away 1 eighth, which works out to 2 over 48, which works out to 1 over 24. Alright, well, we've already filled up an entire page, but we're not quite done yet, are we? Because we still need to actually calculate the coordinates of the center of mass. But all that really remains to be done at this point is a little bit of fraction arithmetic. For example, and here I'm just going to squeeze it in on the side here. Here we have x bar, which can be found by taking the moment about the y-axis, which is 1 over 28, and dividing it by the total mass, which was 1 over 15. And then for y bar, we can do the same thing, but taking the moment about the x-axis, which is 1 over 24, and dividing it by the total mass, you get 15 over 24.